Good afternoon, Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. We already heard about innovation and about different types of load application, and I'm talking about innovation with a different type of load application. If we talk about short stems at all, we see very often pictures like that with a high range of different types of prosthesis. But if we focus on that, we can see that there's not really a systematic arrangement. So if we look at this on a chronological way, we can see there were already some short stems on the market. On the left side, you can see that myotype, which was already introduced by Michael Morlock, the CFP prosthesis. And if you go more to the right side, you can see there are some newer generation of short stems. And we are confronted with terms like calcar fixation and anatomical restoration. So what about the anatomical situation? If we focus on the femoral neck, and we do have to focus the femoral neck if we talk about short stems, we can perform different types of resections. We can perform a very proximal resection, subcapital. We can perform a very low distal resection, or we can perform a resection which is between these both types, so-called neck, partial neck preserving or partial neck resection. And this is already published. So we have to be aware that it is possible, if we perform our surgical procedure, that it is possible to perform different types of femoral neck resection, a very proximal one, a very distal one, or something which is between them. And that has had some influence of the development of newer prostheses. And Professor Jerosch from Neuss, he already made some consideration about this topic. So he made a classification from A to C. A are very proximal fixating prostheses. C are short straight stem with an almost diaphyseal fixation. And between we have this short stem and especially this type B1 with a partial neck retention or neck resection. What does it mean in order to the design of the prosthesis? In the first row, we have this proximal cutting neck retention prosthesis. We already have seen some pictures of types of this, like the Silent or Spiron prosthesis. I never want to revise the cut prosthesis with this particular surface. And on the bottom line, these neck resecting prostheses, like the Fitmore stem. And in between, we have some other types with partial neck preserving or partial neck resecting technique, and the philosophy of the anchoring is most likely a calcar guiding philosophy. So let's focus on this. There are some on the market, and if we differentiate between them, there are some prostheses or some designs which makes an opportunity to modify the offset variation, either with different CCD angles, like the metaprosthesis, or with different types of offset, standard or lateralized, for example, the Optimus stem. If you focus the other stems, they do not have this option. So what does it mean for our surgical procedure? We have to go back to the patient's anatomy again and have to reflect what's the best positioning of the stem. And especially for these B1 type short stems, we have to say goodbye for diaphyseal axis orientation. The orientation is calcar guided. So we have an individual positioning with neutral alignment, varus alignment, or valgus alignment. So here you can see some examples about that. Above, you can see a typical varus situation. We have that very often for male patients. And if you look to the planning and the result after the surgical procedure, you might have the impression that there is a varus position, and that is correct, and that is the philosophy behind this type B1 anchoring stems. And below, a valgus situation, and again, if you see the planning and the postoperative result, the positioning of the stem is a valgus position. So we do not monitor the axis of the diaphysis, we just look more for the individual anatomy of the femoral neck. And this topic is published by Dr. Babisch. He performed some scenarios with valgus angles and varus angles and neutral CCD situations. And he made some planning and he evaluated the possibility to reconstruct leg length and offset. And if you can see the results, there are some prostheses with a big deviation, 10 millimeters or more, but there are some other types of prostheses which make a very precise reconstruction of offset, leg length, or CCD angle, or whatever. Another point, another very important point, is the axial view. The already mentioned book from Professor Jörösch, he defined a new term, the so-called axial three-point fixation in posterior, anterior, posterior, which means that type B1 prostheses have something which we call anterior tilt. And that is very important because there are some biomechanical studies reporting that this mechanism provides high primary stability, and especially for rotation and axial load transfer, the stability improves compared to other stems. And another very big important point for the, practical performance is it is not necessary to apply a rotation to the stem to achieve or simulate the proximal anterorotation of the femur, because the anter-shifting of the center of rotation is provided by this anterior tilt positioning. And you can see that here in this animation. With the shifting of the center of rotation more anteriorly, we can achieve better range of movement. Here you can see an X-ray about that issue. So in conclusion, if we talk about short stems, there are different types of design in order to the anatomical situation of the femoral neck. The very proximal resecting system have a limited indication. Professor Morlock just demonstrated that in the presentation before. The so-called partial neck preserving or neck resecting systems, type B1, they require an individual operation technique, especially the resection is mandatory, that it has to be performed very precisely in order to the preoperative planning. But a philosophy like that covers a lot of indication with a perfect reconstruction of anatomy. And of course, if we compare the techniques for surgical procedure with short stems at all to other traditional stems, they are definitely muscle and tendon sparing. So partial neck resecting systems is a very interesting variation of short stems, and they perform with a reconstruction of the patient-specific anatomy with individual resection and positioning. And if we compare different types of prostheses, an optimum will be achieved if we have different CCD angles or different options for lateral and standard offset. Thank you very much.